If you've been using SwiftUI, there's a good chance that you've called the modifier onTapGesture. This modifier is very convenient because it allows you to define a closure that will be called when the user taps on the view that the modifier has been attached to. However, you want to be careful when you use this modifier because it can easily turn into a really bad practice. So let's take a look at a couple of use cases. In this first use case, we use the modifier onTapGesture to start prefetching some data over the network when the user taps on a view. This is a good use case for the modifier onTapGesture because it is used to trigger an action that will be completely transparent to the user. Now let's have a look at a second use case. Here, the modifier onTapGesture is being used to display a model view. And in this use case, using the modifier onTapGesture is actually a very bad practice. The reason is that presenting a view modally is a user-facing action, and for user-facing actions, it's much better to use a button than to use the modifier onTapGesture. The reason why is because using a button will bring a lot of desirable side effects. For example, the action will become visible to the accessibility layer, and the view will have a highlighted state that shows a visual feedback when the user presses the button. So remember, even though it can be tempting to call a modifier rather than to wrap a complex view inside a button, if you're implementing an action that's visible to the user, then you definitely want to use a button. That's all for this video. I hope you've enjoyed this new format. Let me know in the comments if you have some idea of topics for future episodes. Thank you for watching and see you next time.